creation is one of the key pillars in virtual production. It's the first part of the puzzle. In this chapter, we'll talk about key points to keep in mind when capturing or acquiring plate content and creating real-time content. We'll go over what to look out for if you're thinking about creating your own virtual environment. You may decide to shoot your own plates, hire a specialty vendor, use stock assets, or generate your own computer graphics content. There's no one-size-fits-all, but there are some technical guardrails to be aware of that will set you up for success. Before you do anything, identify what exactly are the elements that need to be captured using on-set virtual production. What's the location? What time of day is it? Will subjects need to interact with anything in the virtual environment? This will help you decide if you need 2D, 3D assets, or all of the above.
Some approaches lean more towards the 2D, especially where it might be traveling sequences. That works really, really well with 2D plate capture. But where you might want to have control of certain elements of your scene on the day, you may want to go 3D. So there's no right and wrong. It just depends on what you want to capture and what kind of control you want to have on the set.
All teams need to be in sync with the director and key creatives. It's very helpful to have storyboards and prepare carefully in advance so that everyone knows the plan inside and out before going in. Let's start with some tips on plate capture for LED volumes. Pop quiz. If you needed to create a plate for display on an LED wall, where should you start? That's right, the camera. Before you begin shooting, check the Netflix-approved list of cameras to make sure the tools you're using are capable of producing an acceptable image for your purpose. Anytime your project requires high levels of visual effects and compositing, you should favor capturing in RAW or uncompressed format. When we say RAW, that means minimally processed pre-debayer sensor data. You'll also want to make sure that the output codec from your camera is compatible with your specs for final delivery. Low data rates can lead to unwanted image artifacts like macro blocking. At a capture rate of 24 FPS, you need a minimum recorded data rate of 240 megabits per second. As the frame rate increases, so should the minimum data rate. Your capture resolution should match the resolution of your intended LED wall. Every camera needs to have a minimum resolution of 3840 by 2160. No cutting corners here. Upscaling is not an option. Low-res capture could lead to aliasing and moiré patterns. Luckily, there are a wide variety of cameras on the market that meet these resolution requirements. In terms of frame rate, you aren't limited to 24 FPS, but it is highly recommended that your capture rate is matched to your show's intended frame rate. You may or may not need to use multiple cameras to capture your plates. A single camera system can sometimes do the trick.
Is that a great shot of an area I really liked?
2D plates is a process that has been happening for a long time for post-visual effects, and the idea is that you go and capture real-life plates. Maybe it's based on a real environment, or maybe it's a stretch of road that you want to use to traditionally replace green screen and post VFX. 2D plates are captured using something called an array rig. So what it essentially is just cameras all stitched together to capture wide field of view, and then what they capture is called plates, and what you can do is take that and use them to project onto an LED wall.
In many situations, like driving process shots, for example, we will use a multi-camera array. This may mean 3 cameras, 9 cameras, or a whole slew of cameras, all set up in a specific pattern. Camera arrays can be configured in an infinite number of ways, depending on the needs of your specific production. When using a multi-camera array, you also need to be mindful of sensor sync between all of the cameras. Use a dedicated Genlock device to ensure each camera is capturing simultaneously. Don't skip this step, or you could end up with frame mismatches between systems, and then the VFX team will have to stitch the images across multiple planes of view. Don't burden your VFX teams with extra work. Be a team player and get it right in camera as much as possible. When positioning your cameras, be mindful of the perspective. Mismatched perspectives will not only cause headaches for everyone on set, but for the viewers at home as well. Improper perspective and angles can also be very challenging for VFX teams to correct. So run through your checklist. How are the cameras angled? How high or low to the ground are they positioned? Will the perspective of your plates be in conflict with the creative intent of the DP? You've got to think about it from every angle. Your choice of lenses is very important, as this also affects the perspective. No lens is perfect. And if they were, that would probably make the world a pretty boring place, wouldn't it? Every lens on the market exhibits some level of distortion. Your DP may even prefer lenses with distinct distortion characteristics. It's all about selecting the right tool for the job. Keep in mind that longer focal length lenses tend to show less distortion characteristics versus wider focal lengths. When shooting plates for a volume, don't forget the LED panel is a light source to be captured in camera, not a display to be viewed with the human eye. Always preview the output as captured by the camera, not how the panels appear on set to your eye. Exposure is important no matter what you're shooting, but when capturing plates for virtual production, it's even more important to avoid under and overexposure, as these attributes will be burned in when displayed on the LED wall. Since we're shooting motion pictures, motion is naturally going to be a key consideration. Make sure you're avoiding rolling shutter effects, motion artifacts, and judder that can destroy the illusion. Image stabilization is vital when capturing plates. This is not the time to go for the handheld Jason Bourne-style camera work. Shaky footage may require heavy post-processing to stabilize. This is not only time-consuming and costly, but will also lower your captured resolution, since digital stabilization generally requires cropping in on the image. Depth of field can set your image apart, literally and figuratively. For plates, focus falloff needs to match the scene for it to be believable. In most scenarios, it's advisable to capture plates with a deep depth of field, which allows VFX teams to dial in blur characteristics as necessary. During color correction, stay away from overly creative grades for content on the LED panels. Otherwise, you're effectively double LUTing the content. Another key thing to consider is processing time. Make sure your post-producer understands exactly what you're capturing so they can account for enough VFX editors to handle the workload. With potentially multiple cameras filming all directions for minutes at a time, that's a lot of data to be processed, selects to be made, and should be considered for both the budget and schedule.